स्टूडेंट यू कैन सी दैट दिस इज द मेल इन्फ्लोरिसेंस ऑफ मेज. यूजली द मेल इन्फ्लोरिसेंस कम्स आउट फर्स्ट एंड यू कैन सी दीज आर मेल फ्लोरेट्स. एंथर्स विल कम आउट ऑफ दीज फ्लोरेट्स एंड दीज विल स्टार्ट शेडिंग द पोलन्स. बट यू कैन सी दैट देर इज नो कॉब स्टिल. The cob is actually the female inflorescence. So in maize, because it is cross-pollinated, so its mechanism is that it is protoandrous, that its male parts comes out first, and then after a few days, its female parts appears from mid of the stem. But you can see that there is no female inflorescence yet. So this will start shedding pollen first, and its pollen will be received by the cob of the neighboring plants.
There are two factors in maize which promote cross pollination. One is that the tassel, which is the male part, it matures earlier, it sheds pollen, and then the silk emerges from the cob, which is the female part, and their time doesn't match usually. Remember, I am saying usually, not always. Sometime it also happens that the pollen grain and the silk both are ready for pollination at the same time. But usually the silk emerges when all the pollen from the same plant has already been shed. So no more pollen is available for its own cob. So this is one factor. The other factor is that if the pollen falls on the silk of same plant, the pollen tube will grow very slowly. This is due to the mechanism of self-incompatibility, where pollen grain develops its pollen tube very slowly because the genetic makeup of the silk, or you can call it pollen, you can call it style of the ovary, has same genetic makeup as that of the pollen grain. And for example, if two pollen fall on the silk at the same time, one is from the same plant and other is from the neighboring plant with different genetic makeup, then the pollen grain from the neighboring plant will develop its pollen tube very fast, its pollen tube will grow very fast, and it will pollinate.
This tassel or male inflorescence I am showing to you, this is a bit later stage which I have shown you earlier. Its flower starts opening from the top and moves towards the bottom. You can see these are the anthers. They have come out of the florets. They are shedding pollen at this stage. Tomorrow you will see that anthers from here will come out, and the next day you will see that anthers from here have come out of the florets and shedding the pollens. But still you can't see any female part or cob in this plant. Student, this is the female inflorescence which you normally call the cob. So you can see that these are the styles of the ovary. Normally you know that normally only stigma receives the pollen grain, but in case of maize, whole the style is can receive the pollen grain and can take it inside, and then this is just like a tube. You see one thread, this is just like a tube. It takes the pollen inside it and it guides it to the ovule. So you can do another thing. If you want to see that how many seeds will be there in the cob, you can count these threads, because one style is coming out from the one ovule, and that ovule will be converted into one seed. So number of these you can say it here like structure, you can say these threads are equal to the number of seeds in the cob. So this is at a very juvenile stage and it is receptive now, and it remains receptive for 2 to 3 days depending upon the weather conditions. And if you see the male part of the same plant, you can see this, that this already has shed all the pollens and there are no pollens in this plant, because I have told you earlier that it is protoandrous and its male part ripens first, male part gives pollen first. So its cob is at very juvenile stage. If you want to see a bit later stage, you can see this cob. This is still receptive. And if you see yet another stage, which is a bit later than this, you can see this one. When you see the threads become like this, they are withered, they are very dry, it means that the pollination has occurred and there is no job of these threads is left. So these become these start withering. And this is a mature cob now, you can see. So this is the ideal male part, we call it tessel. This is shedding pollen at this time. This has started shedding pollen from the top. These have no pollens now. They have given their pollen yesterday or day before yesterday. So this portion is giving pollen today. If you give a jerk to this plant, you will see a powder or cloud type coming out of this these anthers. These are basically pollen grains. One maize plant produces 250 million pollen grains, which are usually carried to the female part by wind. If I give it a jerk, you will see that some powder will come out of this. You can see the anther morphology very clear. Three anthers from one floret are coming out, and we have shed it, and you can see that the pollen grain is falling on the neighboring leaves. These are the pollen grains on the leaf. You can see the pollen grain on my fingertip. You can see a lot of pollen grain over here falling on this leaf, this one, this one. This is the powder-like material, is basically pollen grains.